हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई हार्टली वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द बैलेंसिंग ऑफ केमिकल इक्वेशन। एज यू नो, बैलेंसिंग ऑफ केमिकल इक्वेशन इज वेरी नेसेसरी फॉर अप्लाइंग द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास। वी हैव एन एग्जांपल, दैट इज आयरन रिएक्ट विथ वाटर टू गिव्स Fe3O4 प्लस H2। So this equation is appearing, this is in balance. So how to balance this chemical reaction? How to balance this chemical equation? So you have to make a circle or a boxes around each reactant or product. So what step should be followed for balancing chemical equation? So step number one, you have to make a table like this. First you have to make a table. In the left side you have to write elements, then in column 1 you have to write reactant, here you have to write product. So in first column you have to write each elements. So the elements are iron, hydrogen and oxygen. There are three elements, three type of elements in reactant and in products. So how this reaction should be balanced? Here in the reactant side, the number of iron is 1, and in react product side number of iron is 3. So first you have to write numbers of each elements. So iron 1, iron 3, then hydrogen 2, in product side it is 2, reactant side oxygen 1, and product side oxygen 4. So it's appearing that there is a imbalance of chemical reaction, because number of atoms of reactant and product, number of atoms of reactant and number of atoms of product are not similar. Similar but not in the similar to the number. So which element should be balanced first? How can we judge? We can judge by looking this table. So there is a big which element having bigger number? So in the table it is showing that oxygen having bigger number. So these four number having who having this side, yani product side having four number. So how this molecule should be balanced? So it having four. So for balancing oxygen we have to multiplication of four on reactant side. So again first we have to write an equation, Fe plus H2O then gives Fe3O4 and H2. So step number one, first you have to make a closed circle, then you have to step number two, make a table, then write numbers. Step number three, again write an equation, then we have to multiply bigger number. So oxygen having four on product side and one on the reaction side. So we have to balance this four. So four should be multiplied to the left side. So in this reactant, we have multiplied four. So here we have multiplication of four. So four oxygen on reactant side and four oxygen on product side. Oxygen is balanced. Now, when we multiplied four on reactant side in water molecule, so after that, hydrogen unbalanced, because in the left side earlier the hydrogen number was 2, but when we multiply 4 in the reactant side we get 4 to the 8 number of atom on the reactant. So hydrogen having 8 atoms, and in the product side there is a 2 atom. So how should be balanced? So for balancing this we have to multiply it 4. So after multiplying this 4, now hydrogen is also balanced. Now step number 3, you are looking that there is a 3 atoms of iron. So how this iron should be balanced? So again you have to multiply it by 3 on iron side. So when you multiply it here 3, so our reaction is like this. So just check how our reactant and product number of atoms in the reactant and product are equal or not. So look here, 3 number of iron in the reactant side, 3 number of iron in the product side, 4 to the 8 atoms of hydrogen in the reactant side and 4 to the 8 atoms of hydrogen in the product side, 4 atoms of oxygen in the reactant side and 4 atoms of oxygen on the product side. So we can say that this chemical reaction or equation of this chemical reaction is balanced. So you can take more example for balancing such type of chemical reaction. Again, I am revising steps of balancing a chemical reaction. First, we have to know, you do not change number of atoms, means you do not change the molecular formula. You can't change atomicity in the reaction. So how our reaction should be balanced? How can be balanced? First, you have to make in circle around each reactant and product. Step number one, first you have to make circle. Then step two, you have to make a table, and in the table number of atoms of each element in the reactant side and in the product side, you have to make numbers. Step number three, write again the skeleton equation. This is called skeleton equation. Then step number four, identify the bigger number of elements in the reactant or product side. So that number should be multiplied for balancing with that element first. So we have taken example, here is a 4. Another number may be for any type of reaction. For a particular reaction, different type of numbers you can take. So again, gradually you have to multiply numbers with reactant side and with product side in the front of molecular formula. Where you have to put the numbers? In the front of molecular formula, not after the molecular formula. In the front of molecular formula, you have to multiply. Then check again, if numbers in the reactant and product side equal, then elements are balanced. So by this method, you can take more examples in class 10th book and also in the further classes. There are some chemical equation which can be balanced, and there are various methods. So for class 10th, there was a heat and trial method. So which method we have used? Heat and trial method for balancing chemical reaction. I am going to give you some more examples, so you have to solve yourself. Okay, so this is homework for you. One example I am giving you. Barium chloride BSO4 plus Na2SO4 gives Na2SO4 barium sulfate plus NaCl. So by following this step, you have to balance this chemical reaction, this chemical equation. So balance, please balance this chemical equation, and you have to practice more examples. I will tell you further examples of your syllabus in the next video. So please follow these steps, practice more examples, and if you have any problem or you have any query, you can comment on my channel Science Everywhere on the YouTube. Thank you.